Hello everybody, I'm John Riddle, and today we're going to be talking about Sketchbook. Sketchbook is an amazing software for drawings and sketches, and it also includes a robust set of animation tools. Now, Sketchbook is no longer under the Autodesk company, so it's now paid software for Windows and MacOS computers, but it's still free for tablets and smartphones. In this video, we will use the desktop version called Sketchbook Pro. If you are using the free version for tablets and smartphones, the interface may look different. When you launch Sketchbook, a blank white canvas shows up with several features around it. If your interface is different for any reason, reset it by going to Edit, Preferences, and then to Factory Defaults. At the top, you get the main toolbar with all the features available. On the left side, you have the paintbrush palette with all the drawing tools. In the bottom left corner, there's the lagoon wheel optimized for digital pens. You can click and drag from any button or right-click on the canvas to enable any tool quickly. You can also close any palette with its red button, reopening it from the Window tab. The blank canvas has a default size you can check and adjust from Image, Canvas Size. Alternatively, you can enable the Crop tool and click and drag on the canvas to resize it, entering precise values above and applying with OK. To start drawing, enable any tool from the brush palette. You can brush freehand by clicking and dragging on the canvas. You can disable the tool by pressing the Escape key and undo any drawing made with Control or Command and Z, or with the Undo Redo buttons at the top. Each brush tool in Sketchbook has its own unique style, from simple pencils to airbrushes, markers, ballpoint pens, or paint brushes. Open the brush library to browse through the entire list, and open the brush properties to change brush settings while checking the preview. While drawing, hold down the spacebar key to show a set of visualization tools in order to zoom in and out, rotate the canvas, or pan around the workspace. To control your brush, you can use the brush puck and the color puck. Click and drag on the brush puck vertically to set the brush transparency and horizontally to adjust the brush size. Click on the color puck to set the brush color, such as its saturation and brightness. You can also enable the eyedropper tool to pick a specific color from the canvas. For more advanced color settings, open the color editor at the top. There are several advanced tools for your drawing. Enable steady stroke to brush by keeping a certain distance. Use predictive stroke to correct the curves of freehand brushes. Withdraw style, you can draw straight segments, rectangles, or circles by clicking and dragging on the canvas. Sketchbook includes several drawing aids at the top to ease your work. Enable the Guides feature and select Ruler to draw straight lines laying on a ruler. Move and rotate the ruler by dragging its nodes, checking angle and nodes position at the bottom. You can also enable the Curve ruler to draw curves, or the Ellipse tool to drop perfect ellipses. You can also choose the French Curve tool to drop a variety of preset curves chosen from the top node. Enable Perspective Guides to draw with perspective. Select the number of vanishing points, adjust them as needed, and start drawing. You can also disable snapping, lock nodes, or hide the guidelines with the options at the top. Another powerful feature is the symmetry tool, which lets you draw on both sides of a central axis or even multiple axes. This tool can be used in combination with other drawing aids if you need. The brush palette collects other special brushes. Enable the smear, blur, or the sharpen tools to refine your brush strokes by adjusting their shape, blurriness, or enhancing details. Use the eraser tool to click and remove your brushes, adjusting size and hardness from the brush puck. At the top, you get the flood fill tool, useful to quickly fill closed shapes or even the entire canvas with color. You can choose between a solid fill color, a linear gradient, or a radial gradient. If you apply any gradient, move its nodes to adjust it, and select any node to change its color from the color puck. You can also click on the dashed line to add more nodes, or use the cross icon to remove any node. Sketchbook Pro hosts layers to help you manage drawings and objects on your canvas. Click on Layers at the top to show all the layers present in your project. By default, Layer 1 with all your drawings and a background layer for the plain white color of your canvas. Click on the plus button to create a new independent layer. Select it by clicking on it and start drawing in there. These multiple layers are very useful to manage complex projects. Use the eye icon next to each layer to hide or show it. You can hide the background layer to draw on a fully transparent background shown as a checkerboard pattern. You can also drag any layer from the double arrow icon to change its order of visibility and adjust its opacity by dragging on the blue bar, making the layer content more or less transparent. For more options, select a layer and drag it from the small circle. This allows you to lock the layer to prevent modifications, but also rename, delete, or duplicate the layer. If you need to flip a layer, select it and go to Image Mirror Layer or Flip Layer Vertically. The selection tools can be very useful to select specific areas of your canvas. Head to Select and enable Rectangle or Oval to drop selection shapes by clicking and dragging on the canvas. Choose the Lasso tool to click and drag and draw a freehand selection region, and the Magic Wand tool to select delimited regions with a single click. The selection contours are shown with dashed lines and allow drawings and modifications only within it. You can also cut, copy, and paste this region with Ctrl or Command and X, C, or V into a new independent layer. At the top, enable Add to unify regions, Remove to subtract them, or Invert to invert the selection and exclude your drawings from the defined area. Use Deselect to remove any selection region present. You can use the Transform tools to edit any selected layer. Enable the Quick Transform tool under the Entire Layer option to move, scale, or rotate the entire layer through the wheel. Make sure to apply by clicking on the check mark. Switch to the Transform tool to modify any layer with its nodes by scaling or distorting from the top. To import images in your canvas, go to File, Add Image. This can be moved and edited through the Quick Transform wheel, just like any other layer. Images are independent layers where you can draw as you like. You can also go to Image, Adjust to correct brightness, contrast, saturation, and much more. To add text and titles, enable Add Text layer at the top and set text content, font style, size, and color. Click on OK to generate text as an independent layer and move and edit it as you need. To edit its content and appearance, head to the Layer Options, then to Edit Text Layer. Unlike images, text layers do not allow drawings on it unless you rasterize text first from the Layer Options. To save your project, go to File, Save As. Choose a TIFF file format to save your project with all of its layers inside. Whereas, select a JPEG format to flatten all your layers into a rendered image, switching to PNG if you also want to save any transparent area if present. In Sketchbook Pro, you can also create animations with flipbook projects. From File, New Flipbook, you can open a new flipbook project with proper canvas size and number of frames per second. As you apply, the flipbook project opens, showing a frame timeline at the bottom. The animation is essentially created by drawing on sequential canvases, with each canvas representing a frame in your animation when played. In this case, each canvas frame has a maximum of 4 layers each. To save your animation with all layers and frames, go to File, Save As, obtaining a SKBA file format. If you want to export and share your animation, go to File, Export Flipbook, selecting between a GIF file or an MP4 video. Hey, thank you very much for watching this tutorial, and be sure to visit our YouTube channel and website where we offer loads of free resources to help you get the most out of other amazing software and products you can use for digital drawing.